Yes, welcome friends. Let us go for the next part of discussion, that is oxyacids of oxygen family. Whereas as per the definition given, oxyacids are those compounds which are consisting of oxygen followed by what? Hydrogen. They are having ability to generate H plus ion acids acting as source of protons, and that proton has to come from the cleavage of the O and H connectivity. Such kind of nature containing compounds are said to be the oxyacids. And in this particular 6th group element, there are two important elements for the discussion. For every variety of the thing, remaining all are nominal. That is oxygen followed by what? Sulfur. Oxygen does not form any kind of oxyacids. It will take the help of some other elements to form the oxyacids. But oxyacid itself is consisting of oxygen. Hence, specially oxygen does not form any kind of oxyacids. Hence, just we are having only one particular element and its related oxyacids, that is sulfur. Sulfur forms oxyacids because sulfur is having NS2NP4, that too 3S2 3P4, expandable valency, vacant d orbitals and all the things, and having ability to form pi bonds with the oxygen, especially P pi bonds, D pi P pi bonds. Hence, the sulfur can form oxyacids. And moreover, to go for the clear understanding and the brief understanding of the oxyacids, sulfur is showing two different varieties of oxidation states. One is highest possible oxidation state, which is equal to its group number, that is 6. That is plus 6 oxidation state containing oxyacids of sulfur are known as ic acids. Ic stands for highest. Whereas whichever is there next to the highest, highest is plus 6. Whereas next to highest is less by 2 units. That is what? Plus 4. Plus 4 oxidation state containing oxyacids of sulfur are said to be US acids. US stands for sulfur with plus 4 oxidation state, and ic stands for sulfur with plus 6 oxidation state. There are once again two varieties of oxyacids, that is simple oxyacids. Simple oxyacids, the meaning is the elemental atom sulfur followed by oxygen followed by hydrogen. These elements are present. Whereas there are some other oxyacids where here instead of oxygen, oxygens are replaced by sulfur atoms. Here also the chemical composition is same, but instead of regular acids, some of the oxygen atoms are replaced by sulfur. As a result, forms new acids. Those acids are known as thioacids. Now we will discuss the normal acids first, and normal acids related structures, formulas, and the name, why it was came. Then after we will go for the thioacids and corresponding features. Let us go for the normal acids. Before going to the normal acids, one particular thing that has to be remembered is, in every variety of the sulfur related acids, one thing is very clear, that is sulfur definitely consisting of one double bond with oxygen and definitely consisting of one single bond with the OH. That is S double bond O, S OH is compulsory for every sulfur atom present in every variety of the sulfur related oxy acids. Now let us move our discussion towards the sulfur related acids, that is sulfur related oxy acids. See, oxyacids are sulfur, whereas the chemical composition is sulfur, hydrogen as well as the oxygen with the suffixes of ABC. Whereas the highest oxidation state is plus 6, and that is said to be generally ic system, that is ic acid. Whereas the next to highest oxidation state is decreased by 2 units, that is plus 4, and that particular acid is said to be US acid. This sulfur related ic acids related discussion. Sulfur with highest oxidation state plus 6 containing simple monomeric system is sulfuric acid. Sulfuric acid, sulfur connected with oxygen with double bond, sulfur connected with OH. But in order to fill its 6 as oxidation state, it is connected with another double bond O and connected with another single bond OH. The total formula is H2SO4. Sulfur is maintaining plus 6 as the oxidation state. Hence, this is said to be sulfuric acid, the simplest acid. And the second one is, here it is derivative of, remaining all are derivatives of sulfuric acid.
And in this case, instead of this particular S and OH connectivity, in between this S and OH, another one oxygen is inserted. OO bond is present. OO bond is said to be peroxy bond. Hence, this particular acid is known as peroxy bond containing sulfuric acid. The name itself indicates it is sulfuric acid in the beginning, but now peroxide bond is present. Peroxide bond is having two oxygens. One is regular. How many oxygens are extra? Yes, it is having one oxygen extra. Such kind of sulfuric acid in association with one extra oxygen. Yes, in this peroxy, one peroxy bond is extra, and in that peroxy bond, one is of regular oxygen and second one is extra added oxygen. Hence the formula is H2SO4 plus oxygen, that is H2SO5. And name is given as, yes, sulfur is maintaining 6 oxidation state, hence it is sulfuric acid. Sulfuric acid followed by what? How many peroxy bonds are there? One peroxy bond. Maximum it can form 2. Out of these, possibility is there, that is one peroxy bond is formed, hence it is said to be what? Peroxy monosulfuric acid. Otherwise monoperoxy sulfuric acid. It is also known as what? Carous acid. And the next one is peroxy disulfuric acid. The meaning is peroxy bond is present, followed by what? Two sulfuric acids combination is present. That's what it is. Every acid of sulfur is sulfuric acid, that is identified by its corresponding oxidation state plus 6, and that too, two sulfuric acids of Eakin state are connected with one another in such a way that in between them peroxy bond is present. This is different from this. This is not monomeric, this is dimeric state. Hence it is said to be what? Peroxy disulfuric acid. Hence this is peroxy disulfuric acid. It is also known as Marshall acid. Whereas the formula is H2S2O8. In between these two sulfur atoms, see, sulfur is connected with OH. Sulfur is connected with OH. These two sulfurs are connected by a peroxy bond. Hence, extra, how many oxygens we are getting less? Two oxygens we are getting less. It is sulfuric acid, two sulfuric acids less by two hydrogen atoms. Hence, double of this H2, after removing two hydrogens, 2 plus 2, 4, 4 minus 2, 2, S2O8, H2S2O8, that is said to be what? Marshall acid. The other name is peroxy disulfuric acid. There is another important sulfur related dimeric acid, that is said to be pyrosulfuric acid. Pyro stands for what? Pyro. The meaning of pyro is two simple units minus water. Two simple units are connected by elimination of water. Water molecule is said to be what? Pyro. Yes, on heating, elimination of water takes place. Just like anhydride, two units are combined with elimination of water and the resultant product is said to be what? Pyro. Hence this is pyrosulfuric acid, two sulfuric acids with elimination of water. That is pyrosulfuric acid, 2, if it is 2, H4S2O8 minus water, H2S2O7. This is pyrosulfuric acid. In between the sulfurs, one oxygen is there. Everywhere, in every variety of this particular sulfur related Eak acids, sulfur is maintaining plus 6, sulfur is maintaining plus 6, sulfur is maintaining plus 6. Here also both sulfurs are maintaining plus 6 as the oxidation states. Thus, sulfuric acid, formula H2SO4, structure, sulfur with sp3 hybridization. Sulfur is connected with the double bonds with the two oxygens and single bonded with the two OHs. This is a dibasic acid. Similarly here, peroxy monosulfuric acid, sulfur sp3 hybridization, four connectivities, that is four sigma bonds. One is OH, one is O2H, and double bond OH. It is also acting as a dibasic acid. Similarly, this is also dibasic acid, this is also dibasic acid, and here this is peroxy disulfuric acid and this is pyrosulfuric acid. Along with this, it is also having other three acids. Those acids are having extra quantity of the sulfur than the expected regular and the normal simple and the dimeric structures, and those are said to be the thioacids. We will discuss those thioacids. The next one is sulfurous acid. Sulfurous stands for what? Sulfur with lower oxidation state, that is next to the highest, that is plus 4 oxidation state.
This is sulfurous acid and the corresponding structure. As I said in the beginning, every sulfur is having S double bond O structure followed by OH. This is compulsory. And remaining is OH by maintaining plus 4 as the oxidation state. The remaining one will become what? OH. Hence the formula of the sulfurous acid is H2SO3. It is not SO4. If it is SO4, this is sulfuric. But this is not SO4, this is SO3. That is sulfurous acid. It is also a dibasic acid. But whereas hybridization is not sp, hybridization is also sp3. Whereas one of the hybridized orbital is occupying lone pair of electron, it is also dibasic acid. This is H2SO3. It is also having another one thio acid. Now we will discuss these acids clearly. Then we will make our discussion towards the thio acids. Yes, a detailed applications and the uses related to that of the acids of the sulfur related ink, that is sulfuric acid and its derivatives. Sulfuric acid, H2SO4, the formula. Whereas it is dibasic acid, two protons can be given out in sequence. So therefore it can form two varieties of salts. One is HSO3 minus related salts and SO4 minus related salts. These are said to be sulfates and these are said to be bisulfates. And it is stable. Sulfuric acid is stable because it is maintaining highest oxidation state. It is acting as oxidizing agent. That is, it can reduce its oxidation number. In concentrated conditions, it is acting as good oxidizing agent. And it is also acting as dehydrating agent. It is fond of water. It will eliminate the water from the gases, water from the liquids and all the things. So it is stable oxidizing agent as well as dehydrating agent. The next one is peroxymonosulfuric acid, H2SO5. Whereas, though it is having two OHs, it can lose only one H in the form of H+. Thus, the corresponding salts are HSO4 minus anion containing salts. One variety of salts are formed. Though it is appearing to be two protons containing system, but it is acting as monobasic acid. And it is stable. It is crystalline compound. It is very stable. It is hygroscopic and it is acting as good oxidizing agent because oxygen quantity is very high, hence it is acting as good oxidizing agent also. Whereas when first ionization occurs, it is forming HSO4-, whereas this HSO4- undergoes the dimerization and that leads to the formation of H2S2O8, that is Marshall acid formation takes place, that is peroxy disulfuric acid formation takes place. It is also stable, crystalline, hygroscopic and acting as oxidizing agent. Moreover, it forms only one variety of salt. That salt is S2O8-2- anion containing salts. That is said to be what? Peroxy disulfate ion salts. And the next one is pyrosulfuric acid. It is also crystalline compound. That is solid, crystalline and moreover stable. And it is acting as dehydrating agent and acting as oxidizing agent. Whereas the one variety of salts are formed from this by the liberation of two protons from here. And that is S2O7-2-, that is pyrosulfate salts are formed. S2O7-2- type of salts are formed. And let us move our discussion towards the sulfurous acid H2SO3 corresponding structure. And it is having two OHs. It can lose continuously those two OHs and forms two different varieties of salts. That is dibasic acid. That is with monobasic also salts are formed. Dibasic also salts are formed. If salts are formed, this is HSO3- and this is SO3-2-. These are said to be the sulfite and these are said to be the bisulfite. Whereas it is unstable and not present in corresponding pure state, it is just available in the solution state, that is in aqueous solution state only. It is acting as both oxidizing agent as well as reducing agent. There is no free state existence for this acid of sulfur with lower oxidation state known as sulfurous acid. Yes, the next extension part of the oxyacids is thioacids. where the quantity of the sulfur is greater and some of these sulfur atoms are present in the place of oxygen atoms of the regular or the normal structures are said to be thioacids. Let us go for sulfuric acid related thioacids, whereas we are expecting the oxidation number of sulfur is plus 6. But after replacing oxygens with the sulfurs, there is a change in oxidation numbers also. But we can consider that these of all are the derivatives of the sulfuric acid and the sulfuric acid related simple structures. The first one is thiosulfuric acid. As I know, the sulfuric acid structure is like this. Whereas here one of the oxygen atom is replaced by sulfur, hence it is said to be sulfuric acid with one sulfur is present extra in the place of oxygen, that is one oxygen is replaced by sulfur, is known as thiosulfuric acid. This is thiosulfuric acid and the structure is like this. One of the oxygen is replaced by sulfur. Next is dithionic acid. The meaning of dithionic acid is, this is thiosulfuric acid related generated derivative, whereas in this what happens is two sulfurs are connected with single bond, that is said to be di true of what? Thio, dithionic acid. Two sulfur connectivities containing acid of sulfur is said to be dithionic acid, and the formula of dithionic acid and the structure of dithionic acid is like this. That is, here sulfur atoms are connected with the sigma bond, whereas molecular formula, that is H2, S2. Now many oxygens are there? 2, 2, 2, that is 6. H2S2O6 is the formula for dithionic acid. Next one is polythionic acid. Many sulfurs are there. Those sulfurs are present in between the sulfur-sulfur connectivities of the acid. That is, sulfurs of n numbers are present, and this one is said to be what? Polythionic acid. If you look at the oxidation numbers, sulfur, if I connect, this is sulfur to the sulfur, two sulfurs are there. Average oxidation number of two sulfurs is, that is connected with how many oxygens? Two oxygens here and the oxygen with double bond here, total four, implies average oxidation number of sulfur is two. Average oxidation number of sulfur is 1 plus 1 plus 1 plus 1, total 4. So average oxidation number of sulfur will become equal to 2. Whereas here this particular sulfur atom is maintaining oxidation number of, average oxidation number of sulfur is 1, 2, 3, 4, 2, whereas this sulfur is maintaining oxidation number of 4 and other sulfur is maintaining oxidation number of, see, one of the sulfur is maintaining oxidation number of 4 and other sulfur is maintaining oxidation number of, that is 0 as the oxidation number. In that way, the oxidation number of sulfurs are, one has 0 and other one is what? Plus 4 is the oxidation state. The overall oxidation state is 2. Whereas in the next case, here in this case, that sulfur is maintaining connectivities in such a way that here S double bond O, S double bond O and O is there. So therefore average oxidation state of this sulfur and this sulfur are same and is equal to what? Plus 5 is the oxidation state. Similarly, in case of polythionic acid, here also the same situation. Here sulfur and sulfur connected by single bond, hence oxidation state is decreased by 1 unit. Here sulfur and sulfur is connected by double bond, hence oxidation state is decreased by 2 units, hence it is 4, and average oxidation state is 2. Here the individual and the average all are same, and that is becomes equal to what? Plus 5 is the state, plus 5 is the state. When thio occurs, thio of sulfur-sulfur single bond connectivity occurs, oxidation state is decreased by 1 unit. When thio of sulfur-sulfur double bond occurs, then oxidation state is decreased by 2 units. That's what, in thiosulfuric acid, the sulfur is maintaining oxidation state of plus 4, whereas in these dithionic acid and the polythionic acids, the oxidation number is plus 5. Similarly, let us go for the thioacids of sulfurous acid. There is one acid that is said to be dithionous acid. Us stands for what? Lower oxidation state. Di stands for two units are combined. Yes. Two units are combined in such a way that two sulfurs are connected with the sigma bond. So therefore, if two sulfurs are connected with sigma bond, oxidation state is decreased by 1 unit. What is the regular oxidation state? 4. Now it is decreased by 1 unit in place, but it is 3. So this sulfur maintains oxidation number 3, this sulfur maintains oxidation number 3. Whereas the formula of this compound is H2S2, and how many oxygens are there? 4. H2S2O4 is the formula for the dithionous acid. Does the thio-related acids, if these are derivatives of plus 6 oxidation state, thus we can say it as thioic acids. If these are derivatives of plus 4 oxidation state, then we can say it as thioous acids. Thus, this one is thiosulfuric acid, dithionic acid, polythionic acid, and this one is dithionous acid. Thus, the thiosulfuric acid H2S2O3, this thiosulfuric acid, whereas this free acid is not present for this, but it is existing in the form of its salts. Whereas though it is consisting two OHs, it doesn't form two varieties of salts. Only one variety of salt is formed, and that too with liberation of two protons. That is S2O3 2 minus type of salts are formed. And in these, as we calculated in the last before, sulfur is maintaining oxidation state of plus 4. Hence, it can increase its oxidation number. It is acting as reducing agent because it undergoes oxidation. These are the properties related to the thiosulfuric acid. I will give one example. The salt related to thiosulfuric acid, sodium thiosulfate, Na2S2O3. Such kind of salts are formed where two protons are replaced by the two cations. And the next one is dithionic acid, H2S2O6. Free acid is not known for this also. And moreover, on heating, it undergoes disproportionation, that is plus 5 oxidation state. From plus 5, one is increased to plus 6, one is decreased to plus 4. Thus, H2SO4 and sulfur dioxide formation occurs. Whereas only one variety of salts are formed from this, that is S2O6 minus 2 type of salts are formed. Similarly, polythionic acid, many number of sulfur atoms are present in the mid, not known much. Whereas here also, polythionides are possible, only one variety of salt, that is SnO6-2. Whereas thioous acids related to dithionous acid, dithionous acid oxidation state of the sulfur is found to be plus 3. Not much known about this, that is H2S2O4, as it is regarding its stability, regarding its salts, much information is not known. Thus, the sulfur related acids, if we count sulfuric acid, pyrosulfuric acid, that is peroxysulfuric acid, Marshall acid, peroxydisulfuric acid, and the oleum, that is pyrosulfuric acid, like this sulfur related regular structures are there. Similarly, us related sulfurous acid is there. And if you go for the thio things, thio here in case of sulfuric, we are having three varieties, thiosulfuric, similarly dithionic, similarly polythionic, followed by thio-related acids, that is dithionous acid. Total, these many varieties of acids of sulfur are there, which are generally comes under the category of the oxo acids of sulfur. The all varieties of oxo acids of sulfur in the form of flowchart for our easiness of understanding. All are divided into two categories. One is plus 6 followed by its derivatives, that is ic acids. Second one is plus 4 and its derivatives. Those are all us acids. Whereas once again these are divided into categories. It's simple, that is sulfur and the oxygen nominal combination is there. No excess concentration of sulfur. On behalf of that, they are simple. And second one is excess sulfur is there, those are said to be thio acids. And whereas these are also divided into one simple sulfur atom is there, monomeric structures, more than one sulfur atoms are there, that is based on the number of sulfur atoms, dimers, etc. Thio also, simple thio, similarly dimeric thio and the polymeric thio, the same criteria is present for the us acids. Let us go for the acids, whatever are there. Simple acids related to the sulfur with plus 6 oxidation state. One is monomeric form, simple sulfur atom is present. Those are of two are there. One is sulfuric acid, H2SO4, and second one is peroxymonosulfuric acid. This is peroxymonosulfuric acid. and dimeric form, that is two sulfur atoms are there. This is peroxy disulfuric acid H2S2O8, and H2S2O7 is said to be pyrosulfuric acid. This is peroxy disulfuric acid and this one is pyrosulfuric acid. Let us go for thioacids. The sulfur quantity increases in that simple form, that is one single entity is present in that way, that is thiosulfuric acid H2S2O3, that is said to be thiosulfuric acid. Two units combination is present, that is said to be dimeric form, that is dithiosulfuric acid, dithiosulfuric acid, and this one is polythiosulfuric acid. Similarly, if we focus our attention towards the sulfurous acid, simple and thio, two varieties are there. Simple is sulfurous acid. Thio is consisting of only monomeric, it is not the dimeric. Only dimeric, it is not the monomeric, and here two sulfur atoms are connected with one another. Thus, one independent sulfurous and the other independent sulfurous are joined by a single bond, that is said to be disulfuric acid, dithiosulfuric acid, that is H2S2O4, and is dithiosulfuric acid, which is of belonging to the category of the two entities connected with one another. For our reason, it is of dimeric type, that is dithiosulfuric acid. Thus, these are all are the different varieties of oxo acids of the sulfur present.